kick Poe goes out immediately. That's the appeal of Senator Riso Ontiveros as President Marcos remains mum on the rise of illegal POGOs in the country. She says at this point, POGOs present a clear and present danger and will continue to flourish unless government acts on the matter. She calls on the president to speak decisively and urgently on the issue.
Kung unequivocally kaya niyang mag-push back sa China on the West Philippine Sea issues, bakit parang nagfo-foot dragging dito sa POGO? Okay, kung merong timing siyang hinihintay or meron pa siyang tinitimbang, pero ilang Senate Committee investigations na ang ginawa dati, yung committees on labor at saka economic affairs, at ngayon patapos itong 4 na taong investigasyon ng Committee on Women about POGO-related prostitution, illegal recruitment and detention, the Pastilla scam, at ngayon itong human trafficking, cyber scamming, money laundering, at yung posibleng espionage angle.
For Ontiveros, the POGO industry is not only hounded by failed promises of economic benefits, it also spawns criminal activities, even those deemed as legal. She adds, for her, there's no such thing as a legal POGO.
And it was Duterte who set the first bad example about that. Dahil panahon ng administrasyon niya, practically open door policy sa POGO. How deep and how far does this web of POGOs and POGO politics go? Chair Tengko has to reveal that important piece of information. Tigilin na rin yung pag-distinguish di umano sa mga legal POGO. Kahit yung mga so-called legal POGO, eh, nanganganak ng napakaraming illegal, no? So, that takes away the reason or the excuse for anyone, past or present in government, to sponsor this vile industry.
Senator Ontiveros, meanwhile, vows to get to the bottom of the controversy, hounding suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go. Ontiveros warns, now that Go has been caught lying about her identity, the Senate will not extend to her the same courtesy that they did at the start of the inquiry. She says Go must show up in their next hearing next week or risk being detained by the Senate.
Ubod na lang ng kortesiya on our part previously dahil ang unang pagkakilala namin sa kanya ay kapwa manggagawa sa gobyerno na hindi pa siya earlier pa sinight in contempt. Talagang binigyan ng lahat ng palugi to tell the truth. But now, in the face of this incontrovertible evidence para siya itanggalin, no? Yung galing sa NBI fingerprint matching, kailangan na talaga niyang sumipot at sumagot.
So far, Ontiveros says Go is still in the Philippines based on the Immigration Bureau's monitoring. She also assures the public the mayor would serve her sentence here in the Philippines before being deported if convicted in any of the cases filed against her. Senator Ontiveros says the reported Senate run of the Dutertes next year presents a bigger problem in Philippine politics, the lack of an anti-dynasty law. She says it's about time lawmakers follow the Constitution and pass such measure. Former President Rodrigo Duterte recently denied he and his two sons will be seeking Senate seats in the 2025 elections.
Ang mga Duterte naman, matagal nang nagtayo ng sariling dynasty sa Davao City hanggang sa bansa, hanggang sa House, hanggang sa Office of the Vice President. Almost 40 years yung utos ng konstitusyon sa atin to pass an anti-dynasty law. Unfortunately, human psychology, nobody legislates against interest. At sa ating Kongreso, overrepresented talaga yung mga dynasties.
Ontiveros, meanwhile, says she has no plans yet of running for president in 2028. Right now, she says what's important is to revive the strength of the opposition in the run-up to the midterm elections.
I'm not considering running yet, but what I am 100% considering is that the opposition will run candidates for president, vice president, and across the line. Yun yung tinatrabaho ko the last 2 years, and we will continue to work on it until next year sa midterms and the next 4 years until 2028. Patuloy kaming magpapalakas, and by then, we should be in that position of strength na seseryosohin, hindi lamang ng administrasyon, pero seseryosohin ng ating mga kababayan at ng ating mga botante, whether be opposition or independent, anumang pangalan ang gagamitin namin. But we will be something different and something better.